The treatment of livestock is not the only cause for concern in modern farming. The frequent spraying of highly toxic chemicals like organodimutron constitutes an increasingly serious threat to public health, as farmworker Bill Catchpole and his wife Pat can testify.
Well, he was sent out in the tractor to spray the fields with organodimutron to kill off the miregrass beetle. 3 days later, they come out looking for me and found me unconscious in the cab.
3 days later? You must have been very worried, Pat, when he hadn't returned home for all that time.
No, not really. They worked them long hours on that farm, you know. And I knew Bill's want to do some overtime because we had to save up to pay the milkman that week.
I see. When they found you, Bill, what happened then?
Well, luckily, the boys knew immediately what it was, you know, organodimutron poisoning, because it's always happening. So they called an ambulance and I was rushed off to hospital.
But if organodimutron poisoning is always happening, why do you keep spraying the fields with it?
To keep the miregrass beetle under control. You see, although organodimutron can be lethally poisonous to humans, it's only mildly irritating to the miregrass beetle, so you have to use a heck of a lot of it to do any good.
See, and I believe you were unconscious for quite some time.
4 months, yeah.
It must have been a very difficult time for you, Pat.
Well, it was very inconvenient, yes. We had our daughter Sarah's wedding to organise. It's very hard work with me just doing it.
You carried on with your daughter's wedding, even though Bill here was unconscious?
Well, yes. Sarah and I decided that that's what her dad would have wanted.
And was it Bill?
No.
Well, we made a mistake there. Never mind.
I understand that at one point you were in such a deep coma that the doctor suggested that Pat bring you in a tape cassette to play you. Is that right?
Yeah. Roy Orbison's Greatest Hits.
Presumably in the hope that hearing your favourite singer might trigger some response in you.
Well, I suppose so, though actually we're no particular favourite of mine, really. Pat likes him.
His music holds romantic memories for me.
Well, they weren't with me, though, were they?
Oh, but you like the chap, didn't you?
Oh, he's all right, I suppose. If you like the gangly type.
Anyway, now you seem to have made a recovery, though not a complete one, I believe.
That's right. Ever since I did the spraying, I've been covered in these horrible festering spots.
They're all over him, on his chest, up and down his back, all along his arms and legs.
And indeed, all over his face.
Oh, no, those ones have always been there, haven't they?
Yeah.
The farm Bill Catchpole works on is Church Farm in Essex, owned by Martin Jackson. I asked him why, after so many accidents on his farm involving organodimutron, he persists in using the stuff.
I don't like using it. I don't like using any pesticide. When you're dealing with something as tough as miregrass beetle, you can't afford half measures.
I understand you've been using it now for 5 years, and in that time, 4 of your men have had to be hospitalised.
Yes, I know. We've been very unlucky with the wind.
The wind? What's that got to do with it?
Not everything. While the wind's blowing the stuff away from the tractor cab, you're fine. But if it changes, wallop. You're a man short for 5 months.
Yes, that doesn't seem a very adequate safety precaution, though, does it?
Yeah, well, I suppose it wouldn't to a townie, would it?
What's the fact that I come from a town got to do with it?
Well, if you came from the country, you'd know that we farmers have to rely on the weather for everything. Blast it.
Yes, I assume you've read the warning on the side of the drum.
Bits of it. Look, I've got a farm to run. I don't need no interference from no bunch of well-meaning townies. Got no idea about the country, no country ways.
Well, one of those country ways being that you gas your workers just because the wind happens to have changed direction.
Yeah, that's how we do things out here.
Well, I wonder if we could turn to the... Yes, I wonder if we could turn to the damage done to the wildlife.
Wildlife's a towny word. Pests, we call them.
I see. The rainwater runoff in your fields here goes straight into the River Wear. And recently, in fact, in the last 3 weeks, six herons have been found dead on its banks. How do you account for that?
Foxes, probably. Kill for the sake of it, foxes do.
Well, do they also bleach their victims and inject them with the... Inject them with organophosphorus derivative?
Yeah, cunning creatures, foxes. They probably only kill the herons that have been bleached to make it look like something else did it.
I see. It is, in fact, the opinion of the scientists who've examined the bodies of these herons that they were poisoned by organodimutron.
So what?
Well, so if they're right, that means you're poisoning the water, Mr. Jackson.
Oh, yes. Have you ever seen what herons do in it?
Well, at least they don't fill it with organodimutron.
They do when they fall over dead in it.
So I take it then that you're going to persist with using this chemical?
Well, no, only until I find something stronger.
Is that a swan, Mr. Jackson?
It's a pest.
I think Her Majesty the Queen would be interested to know that you've been shooting swans, Mr. Jackson. Mr. Jackson...
The manufacturer of organodimutron is Chemicide Agrochemicals Limited. I spoke to its public relations officer, Tony Daniels.
Organodimutron is perfectly safe, provided that it's used exactly according to the manufacturer's directions, which are printed quite clearly on the side of the drum.
Yes, one of these directions is that the user should be wearing an all-in-one bodysuit made from rubber at least half an inch thick, as well as a gas mask, isn't it?
Yes.
It's not terribly practical wear for someone driving a tractor, though, is it?
Why not?
Well, I should imagine in the height of summer, it would be insufferably hot.
Well, if farm workers want to put comfort before safety, you can hardly hold us responsible. In any case, we do suggest an alternative.
Yes, robots.
That's right.
The sight of robots driving tractors spraying crops is not yet a very common one on British farms, though, is it?
I don't know. I don't get out to the country very much. I suffer from hay fever.
Pesticides like organodimutron will never be entirely safe. I mean, if they were, they wouldn't be any good at poisoning things, would they?
The crop that organodimutron is used to protect is fetid Meyer grass. Originally grown only in the Camargue, it's now harvested all over Europe in vast quantities for the large EEC subsidy that it attracts. And yet it is, nevertheless, a crop which is almost entirely useless.
Oh, I don't think it's fair to say that it's entirely useless. It may have many uses. We haven't had a chance to find out yet. We've never had this much of the stuff before.
Fetid Meyer grass has now officially been recognised as one of Europe's most pressing problems. It's already the EEC's fastest growing mountain, and the indications are that it's likely to remain so, especially now that the Russians have refused to take any. Faced with this growing crisis, the community's agricultural research scientists are being urged to contrive potential new uses for the crop.
Well, at the moment, we are experimenting with it as a new type of cattle feed. I have to say the results are not very promising.
Why not?
But the cows keep exploding.